As he was wheeled into the Senate chamber shortly after 1 a.m., 92-year-old Robert Byrd made it clear how he felt about being pulled out of bed to vote.
Shame. Shame.
His ire was directed at Republicans who intentionally dragged out debate on a defense spending bill, hoping that, in turn, would hold up the health care bill Democrats desperately want to pass before Christmas.
Not even the darkness outside can conceal the game being played inside this Senate chamber.
It's one of several stalling tactics Republicans have employed in recent days, and they're not apologizing.
I don't think anybody in the room's missed it. We don't think this bill ought to pass, and we're not in a hurry to complete it.
With just 40 senators, Republicans don't have the power to stop the health care bill, just delay it.
What's the point of forcing these votes to be held at the dead of night on Christmas Eve? Why not just move along?
Well, why don't the Democrats say, look, let's sit down, let's work this out? Wouldn't that be the way to do it? They can do anything they want to, and they found that, hey, that isn't the way it goes.
Especially not with a midterm election year right around the corner.
What you do is you make the majority party, the people allegedly in control, look inept, and then you run against them for not being able to accomplish anything. This is standard politics 101.
But Republicans won't need to bother stalling if Democrats can't negotiate an abortion compromise with their lone remaining holdout, pro-life Nebraska Senator Ben Nelson. And there are other problems. Senators still haven't seen the bill or the changes to it, and they still don't know how much it will cost. Nancy Cordes, CBS News, Capitol Hill.
Bob Schieffer is our chief Washington correspondent and anchor of Face the Nation. Bob, all week long we've heard about the twists and turns of health care reform in the Senate. What do you think is going to happen to this bill?
You know, this is some remarkable insight I'm going to give you, Katie, but no one can really say. No one knows, except for the fact that they are talking about spending our tax dollars. This is the part you just want to close your eyes and not look. What's going on now is not crafting a better bill. It's not even about health care. This is about partisanship, about getting votes, about backroom deals. It's about politics. Republicans are against everything. They don't know what's in the bill, but they're against it, so they're trying to slow everything down. Democrats want to get it passed. They don't know what's in the bill either, but they're for most of it. So they're trying to counter the Republican slowdown by putting the Senate on a 24-hour schedule. They had a vote at 1 o'clock this morning. They're going to have another one at 7 o'clock tomorrow. You've got liberal Democrats attacking the president for giving up too much. You've got Rush Limbaugh attacking the Republican leader, Mitch McConnell, for being too soft. At this point, it appears the Democrats are one, maybe two votes away from having the votes to pass this bill. But no one can be certain. No one can say exactly what's in it, how much it's going to cost. What we're seeing here tonight, Katie, is the legislative process at its very worst.
And it really is like watching sausage being made, isn't it? Bob Schieffer, Bob, thanks so much.